Yeah, we're looking at the superposition principle, and in this aspect, we're looking at this second order differential equation of constant coefficient. Superposition principle is just that we need to get, if you look at these second order differential equation, your non-homogeneous part are two parts, whereby you're going to get the what? YP, particular solution for this f of 1, which you can call YP1, then you have to get what? The particular solution for f of 2, which we can call YP2. Okay? So then you now superposition in the sense that you had the effect together, you had the particular, so the YP now will now become YP1 plus YP2. So superposition just adding the several effect together, okay, adding the particular solution together. And in this case, we are still going to use the undetermined coefficients, f of 2 also, it's also a function of x, okay? So you're having one function combined with another functions, they superimpose together, okay? Then don't forget also, you also, before you can get the particular solution, you must also get what? The YH. Get the homogeneous part of that differential equation. Okay, then the general solution will now become still this plus what? Plus your YP. Okay, and your YP in this case is YP1 plus YP2. So that's that on these superposition principle. Second order differential equation equal to this one. Okay, so what we do first, we need to what? We need to get the YH, which is the homogeneous part of the equation. And that will be equal to Y prime, second differential, 3Y plus 2Y equal to 0. Then we get the auxiliary equation of this, which will be equal to R squared plus 3R plus 2 equal to 0. Then we can factorize this, and that will be equal to, okay, factors of 2 is 2 and 1. So how do you use 2 and 1 together? Plus 3, that plus 2, and then plus 1. And when you multiply plus 2 plus 1, you get back your plus 2. So your R now is now minus 2, or what? Or minus 1. Then we can write the homogeneous equation, homogeneous solution as C1, E minus 2X plus C2, E. X. Okay, so that's that now. Now get the particular solution. Divide the equation into two parts. Very simple. This will be Y, this one, the question, plus 2Y equal to the first part, F of X, 1, F1 of X, 3X. And then for this one, you can get the YP1 for this one. The second one, divide the equation into two parts. Again, same thing also, that's what? YP2. Okay, as follows. Okay, so let's get the YP1. The YP1 will be equal to, this is a linear equation. Okay, this linear equation, and that will be equal to AX plus BX. That's AX plus BX, it's linear. So YP1 is this, then we can get the first differential of your particular solution, the first particular solution, which is equal to, if you differentiate this, you have A. Then second differential, YP1, you have 0. Okay, substitute back to your to this place, your YP1, second differential, 0, plus 3 times fourth differential, that's 3A, then plus 2 times what? 2 times y, which is ax plus b, equal to what? Equal to 3x. And this will be equal to 3a, 2 times this one, plus 2ax, and then plus 2b, what do you have here? Equal to 3x. You put the coefficients, 3a plus 2b is equal to 0. Okay, that's constant times. equate the coefficient of x, that will be 2a. This is coefficient of x, 2a equals what? Equal to 3. So a is what? 3 over 2. Then you can come back here and substitute there. And that will be 3 times 3 over 2 plus 2b equal to 0. So that will be 9 over 2 plus 2b equal to 0. So 2b equal to minus 9 over 2. 2b equal to minus 9 over 2. So b will be equal to what? Minus 9 over 2 divided by 2. And that was minus 9 over 4. So the YP1 is equal to what? Go back to the equation. Just for the YP1. So let's quickly get the YP2. For the YP2, let's check it. Let's get the YP2. For the YP2, look at what we have for the right-hand side, the non-homogeneous part there. We are very lucky. None of the R1 and R2 is not equal to 3 here. Your R1 and the R2 are not equal to this. So to make our work fast, then we can have, so YP2, the particular solution for that will be equal to A what? A E3X. Okay, R1, R2 is not equal to what? It's not equal to 3. Okay, so in that case now we can have the first differential, and that will be equal to 3x. The second differential, that will be 9 times 3 again here. Okay, that's second differential. Then we can plug back to the YP2. Can plug back. Okay, so that will be second differential is what? The second differential is 9a e3x plus 3 times first differential, 3a e3x. Okay, then plus 2 into bracket 2 times y, and my y is what? Yp2, that's a. AE3X equal to 10E3X. Okay, so this will be 9. This will be 9. That's 20 altogether. 20A E3X equal to what? 10 what? 10E3X. So E3X can go. Then A is what? 10 over 20. That's F. So in that case now, YP2 now become. We can combine or superimpose YP1 and YP2 together. Okay, so the particular solution now, the YP1, YP, we got to YP1, superimpose them, add them together, YP2. To get the general solution, YG, it will be equal to the homogeneous part, we have it, C1, E minus 2X, plus C2, E minus X, then plus the YP, which will be equal to a superposition principle of a non-homogeneous.